Well, hopefully we're back, ladies and gentlemen. My apologies, and we had a little internet connection, some conspiracy probably, but it looks like if you can, let me know if you can hear me or not. I've gotten plenty of people telling me. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, I don't remember where it went away, but we've got a 7-7 ball game. We had a huge defensive stand that backed Grove back up to their own 40 after they were down at our 32-yard line. But a great punt. Do we have our score up, 7-7?
Yeah.
And anyway, had a great punt. We've had a good couple runs and a hold play. Oh, get out of the end zone.
Pass to Jaden McWilliams, complete. He's going to be right near the first down marker.
No, he's about the 19-yard line. We need to get to about the 22.
I was looking wrong. Let's see.
So that's going to bring up fourth and three or four, which I would expect a punt out of here unless Jax Whitaker sees something that is going to be wide open for him to be able to fake that and pick up the first down. But I would expect a punt here. And it is a punt. Looks like it may have partially gotten blocked, but if not, either way, if it did, it's a good little rugby-style punt all the way down, well, to our 42-yard line. So our defense is going to have to step up and make another stand here. Again, I hope that you guys can hear me out there and hear Jason. And, Jason, thank you so much for working on that and getting that going.
I'm still working on it.
If we are going, still appreciate it. Looks like we got maybe our speed kind of package in. Tyler McCoy at nose guard, 31. It brings up first and 10 for Grove. Let's run straight up the middle. Up about four. Got about 8 minutes 30 seconds left in the first half. Oh, good. I hope that's going to be a hold. Should be a hold.
All right, so I reshared it on the Hillbill Quarterback Club page.
Okay.
Hopefully everybody's getting it.
It's because it's a different link?
Yes, it's a brand new link.
Okay.
Hopefully everybody can try to share that and let everybody know what's going on. You see it? I added it to the actual... original Quarterback Club link page. I'll add it on my Facebook too. Chris is going to grab it and add it too, I imagine. So give everybody get a chance. If you got your Facebooks handy, go ahead and share that with everybody.
All right. Yeah, I'm just letting people know.
Yeah, we were on the wrong Wi-Fi.
Get
that was the whole
there.
Problem.
Get it.
Oh, he dropped it.
Go get that ball.
Oh, no. He's out of bounds regardless. He's out of bounds. He wasn't even close to being in bounds.
Good catch, but he's out of bounds.
Yeah, he wasn't even close to being in bounds. Very good catch, though.
Way to get that ball off, man. He was under some pressure.
Yeah, he had it in his face, that's for sure. Looks like we may have a few people logging in. Sorry for the mix-up. You probably missed a kickoff get ran back by Grove, and since then it's been kind of a defensive struggle on both sides of the ball for both teams.
I got told I may have posted the same link was last time.
It's go to my Facebook page. It's the one I just shared just a few minutes ago. It may be the same info. I don't know.
Yeah.
I didn't change any stream keys or nothing. I just had to reload them. It's like they lined up the punt. Fourth and third down didn't get any net anything. That's a good punt.
Yeah, man, that punter, he is good.
He's a good running back, too.
Go, ball, go, ball, go, ball, go, ball, go, ball, go, ball, go, ball.
Please, Lord.
Yeah, oh, yes. It went in.
Touchback. Woo, doggies. We did not need to start at the 1/2-inch line.
Oh, my goodness. Well, hopefully people can see us and hear us.
Yeah, we got show 60 or so watching right now. So everybody share it, share it, share it, share it. It's easy. Easy peasy.
One button. Maybe two.
Well, you got to find where you want to share it to.
Yeah. Defense has really stepped up. I mean, defense has had a good game. They only scored on a – even though Grove has drove the ball pretty well – whenever they've gotten close to the red zone, we've – oh, dadgummit, we just jumped offside. Illegal motion.
Somebody hears us in Marble City, America. Got some people from Grove watching. Number five's parents. Looks like father's watching. Says, go Grove. Number five's my son. And I'll call his name out for you even because I'm a nice guy. Matt Bush. All right, here
we
go.
Talking back to pass.
First and 15.
A screen to Dylan Walker. Gets hit pretty immediately. Gain of just about 2 yards.
Oof. That was read well by their Grove defense. So this has been a slobber knocker. Off up the middle, Eric Virgil not getting much there out to about the 20, so back to the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to bring up third down and 10 for the Hornets. Kobe Thompson checking in. Jose Gutierrez checking out.
Isom
Smith checking in. Did anybody else go out? Oh, he's coming in running back. Okay, Virgil went out. Gotcha.
Third and 10, we really need to pick up a first down.
Yeah, we need to get some offense generating here. I mean, at this point, both teams really need some offense.
Throw a little low.
Third short.
Oh, he's still up.
He's going to be a yard short. So fourth down and one, do we go for it?
I think we
hard count.
Line up to punt.
Looks like they're going
to
punt.
We line up to punt, and if we see something, we do it. If we're not, we punt it. And so Jackson, again, I'll mention it again. He was featured in a Phoenix story this our paper, Muskogee Phoenix story this week. Talk about how versatile of a player he is on the field.
And he's running it.
It looks like he is going to run it. Get upfield.
He's up,
get up
he's
field.
Up past
that's
the 30. He's
down.
In. That's first
good.
Down. All the way good. To the 35-yard, 36-yard line.
I know Jan's not listening to this, so I can say I'm nice to see him actually running the ball. Excellent play. Excellent play.
Oh, they got a man down.
Ball. Oh, yeah. Yep.
Looks like he might be hurt. Yeah. He kicked his helmet off.
Grove,
maybe he just can't breathe.
Yeah, I'm thinking he might have got the breath knocked out of him. But Grove, player down, and he's up already.
Oh, no, he's limping.
Yeah, he's limping.
Knee, ankle, somewhere, lower leg injury.
Yep, number 55. Mm-hmm. So, great pickup of a first down. We really needed a first down there. My Jets.
That's 7 yards there. That was Jimmy Phillips, senior, one of the captains that coming off a little limp, maybe get taped up and get back in there. Don't ever want to see a senior end of season on an injury, man.
I don't care what.
Let him fight it out, blood, sweat, and tears, but get him taped up, maybe he can get back in there. Need red shirts in high school. Good blocking up front. Logan Harper gets the ball.
Catches it, and that's a completion. Gain of about
7-yard pitch there. if they're going to do that, we ought to just run that all day. It works against OU a lot of times, right?
Yeah.
Yep. 7-yard cushion.
Yep.
Every two plays first down.
Well, I remember, what was that play where we threw it to Logan out there? What, I don't know what game it was, but we threw it to him like 4 times in a row, the same exact play.
Yeah. Was that Muldrow?
No, we didn't do anything. Somebody else.
Fancy at Muldrow, did we?
It was Salisaw.
Was it Salisaw?
And
Johnny does it again.
Yeah,
same play. A little deeper this time.
It's going to be a first down.
Pick up of about 8 this time, so that was a lot more.
So they're going to set him up, right? They're going to keep coming in, keep coming.
And they hit him deep.
He's going to throw it deep. Yep.
They'll do a little hitch and
hitch and go.
I saw Kevin Hill was here today at the game. Longtime youth coach and supporter of the Hilldale Hornets. He's moved to Oklahoma City and got married, teaching school up there. But glad he was able to make it in the house. I didn't have time to talk to him. I felt bad. But Chris referenced that was what's the Hills
at? There we go. We
hit it,
right?
It.
Oh man.
How to get rid of it?
Yeah.
Levi, Wyatt, what are the names?
Gassaway?
Gassaway's ex-stepdad. Anyway, he coached Little League for years, and even after the kids, you know, him and a couple other guys coached the first grade team for like 4 years in a row by them, you know.
Yeah.
So the parents didn't have to do it. Johnny Gross is getting under center. Going to do a pitch to Virgil. There was a lot of traffic in the yard, but I'm not sure if maybe they blocked the wrong people. 2 people hit one. Maybe one should have been lead blocking.
I think we got to keep throwing the ball to the outside. I don't. Their outside pursuit is pretty fast. I mean, we seem like Virgil can't get even that first step.
Yeah, that number 40, Wesley Necrol Downing, is all over the place. He's coming in on a blitz, picked up by Gutierrez. Gross releases the ball deep.
Dylan Walker over the shoulder
and for the touchdown.
No laundry on the field. That's touchdown Hornets.
That was beautiful pitch and catch right there. Dylan Walker had to adjust. He was coming back a little bit and had a full speed come back the other way and managed to get it over the shoulder, never broke stride, and scored.
Oh, my goodness. Great throw by Johnny Football.
Under pressure, too.
Oh, yes. All right. Brings on Jax Whitaker for the point after attempt.
.415 to go.
Oh,
did he kick that out of his hand?
I think so.
I think he did kick that out of his hand.
Yep, and thank goodness, because it was going to get blocked. And that is good. And so it's 4:15 left in the first half. Your Hornets 14. The Grove Ridge Runners 7.
Which is a bird.
Which is a bird.
We're going to go with it.
Yeah.
We don't know that.
I got you.
If it doesn't have to do with medicine names and counting to 5, you can't do it. You don't know, right?
What's that?
So if it doesn't have to do with medicine names and counting to 5, you're not sure.
Yep, that's right. That's all I know.
It's extended year science?
That's it. Something like that. Wow. Well, that's we needed that. We had to fake a punt to get the first down and then kept throwing. Good bounce, good play calling. And Dylan, I mean, he had a good 2 steps on that defender, and Johnny just put the football right where he needed to. And
you know, if he would have had to come back any for that, he'd have been tackled, and it could have probably been knocked away. But
he did.
Fortunately, it went right over his shoulder. He just had to make a quick adjustment, kind of in his movement, didn't slow him down one bit, and scampered right into the west corner of the end zone. Jax kicks it. Yeah. Smart play.
Dadgummit. Went out of play. Yeah, that was a smart play by number 5. And that's a.
They're going to get a block in the back.
Marker for the going out of bounds.
Oh, you think?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe not, but that's what
I
think.
Yeah, I guess it would be. Yep. They actually have to throw the flag. So they'll get the ball at their own 35-yard line. But no chance of running it back for a touchdown.
Nope. Yeah, after that happens, I'm okay with that. But All right, so defense, let's go.
I will say that Darren Hayes is playing like a man on fire tonight on defense.
He is having a really good game. Oh, it's going. It's running. I was like, let's pump the clock, and then we are. So that's good.
So is Lawson? Lawson?
I don't know.
We move him into a nickel slot or something? Looks like it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I believe there might either be an offside or an illegal shift, one of the two. So there's a pickup of about 3 on the play. We'll see what the call is.
So we move Brayson in a little bit, and we've got...
He's playing nickel. We got number 7.
Lamarian out there at corner.
Along with Nyson.
Yep.
I missed the call. What was it?
I was looking at the thing.
Maybe they waved it off?
Yeah, I guess nothing.
We were looking at personnel and missed the call. So obviously there's no call because the ball didn't move unless they declined a penalty, which I can't imagine that happening. Second down to 3. Looking to pass, got pressure coming from the backside.
Why
does he release it?
Yes!
Intercepted.
Go, Jace!
Jace
go,
Walker. It was tipped by, I believe, he might go all the way in. He's going to go all the way in.
Touchdown! Touchdown, Hornets! Ball was tipped. I didn't see
it. I think number 31 tipped it.
Oh, my gosh.
On the wrong. I don't know where it's at.
All right. Well, if somebody could tell me who tipped it, that'd be awesome. Anyway, ball was tipped at the line. We had 2 Hornets have a chance at it. Jace comes down with it and then just literally outruns everybody. It's basically offensive lineman at that time.
I believe that's his second pick 6 of the year, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yep, yes, sir. Jack's on for the point after attempt. High snap again, but he does get it. He gets it through, and we're up 21-7 with 3:44 left in the first half.
That escalated.
Oh, man, what a change in momentum. What a change in momentum. Excellent, excellent. I jumped up a little fast, feel a little lightheaded.
Oh, Chris, you're funny.
I bet our kickoff is almost identical to the last one. Blevins is standing right there. He's like, I want you to kick it right here.
Well, I don't know where that's at. I'm lost.
Well, that's okay. As long as we're broadcasting, that's fine, but...
Yeah, we're broadcasting, but...
And here we go, Jax again, and it is more of a pooch. Call for a fair catch, and he catches it at his own 41. But again, he can't run it back in that instance. So, smart play. And our defense will come back out on the field again.
Nice. So far,
they've outscored our offense.
Scoring.
That's right, which is fine. I don't care. It's team sport.
Is it?
Yes.
Got one of our alumni on YouTube. Says Hildell's breaking the curse this year.
Head off to 24. Oh,
right up the middle. Right big hole. Still on his feet. Knocking people
down. Running everybody over. My goodness.
They're sticking their helmets down, not wrapping up. Poor tackle.
Man, he made a good cut and literally just running people over. Dang, pick up about 20.
Braden Smith coming back in the game. Outside linebacker. Oh, I see. We got out of that nickel package. Braden Smith and Look, he's, oh, he's still, man, come on, guys. That number 55 that walked, left off field, their center.
All right, come on, defense. Let's get a stop here.
Another first down all the way deep in the hill of those for territory, about the 27-yard line. We're going to do a handoff again. Tackle the 20 by 75 Watson Schiller. Pickup of about 7 yards. Going to bring up third down and three for the Ridge Runners. Close to the first down. Going to bring up third down and short. Oh, no, it's lost yards. I'm sorry. I was looking at the wrong hash. Loss of down on the play.
Under pressure. Under pressure.
Hit as he throws. Almost intercepted again.
Michael Easer almost had the ball there.
So that's going to bring up fourth down. And I'm not sure what they're doing there. So fourth and one.
You know what I'm not sure of is why they don't just keep handing it off to 34 or the other guy. My
goodness. Or 28.
Yeah.
Was it 28 or 24?
34 is the
28 was the one that was running
everybody over. But 34, he picks up about 7 yards every time he touches the ball.
Man, they hand it to him. He's got a hole. There's a flag. Timeout taken by Grove.
Oh, my goodness. That was a big hole,
too.
They had
a massive hole.
Thank goodness. Oh, my gosh. All right, well, that's 142 left in the first half. Hornets leading 21-7. I'm assuming we've updated our score, Jason, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is where our defense has been clamping down. Once they get down close to the red zone or in the red zone, we've made some stances, stops. Why am I saying stances? I don't know. But we've made some
defensive
big time
stands.
Stops.
Yeah. We've stopped them.
Yeah. And
it's all good.
Backed them up big time over and over again. So we need to do that here.
Weird. I don't know where that went to.
Is it the bot? Like,
it's still working, but I don't know where it went. I don't see it in the tray anywhere. Oh, we're 12 games into it. We still know how to use the stuff.
Right.
All right. Going empty backfield. Oh, no. 24 is back in the backfield. And they give him the ball. They run that same play they tried to run. He dives across, gets first down. All the way down to the 15-yard line. So first and 10 inside the Hilldale 20.
All right, come on, D.
Pitch out to number 34. He's going around the end. Darren Hayes wraps him up, throws him down about 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage. He's going to bring up second down and we'll say 12, I think, right?
Clock is running. Got him down inbound.
Minute 11 to go. Holding him to 0 points would be a big win for us right here.
Yep.
What was that?
I don't know. They're
they decided to huddle? Not huddle? And the clock's running.
Got two timeouts. I mean, they've got plenty of time still, but.
Oh, well. It's one of those coaches to get the big bucks, right?
Yep. Quick pass.
Over the middle. He's open. And he's down inside the two.
Oh, man.
What's called?
Oh, there's a penalty flag.
Oh. They're going to say.
It's offensive, I think, covered up, maybe? I think he was covered up.
Well, no, he couldn't have been because those other two ran the other side.
There wasn't a receiver out on the left side? Because he was a tight end.
I don't know. I'd be lying if I told you that. Okay.
But it doesn't matter. If there's a penalty flag on the play, that's going to back him up.
Well, if he's covered up, that means a legal man downfield.
Yep, that's what it was.
Taken by the Ridge Runners, so they're gonna sit back and think about it. So they're setting a second and 17 with about 34 seconds to go in the half.
Whew. I know I'm quiet, but I'm nervous. I'm so nervous.
You looking forward to driving Weatherford?
Oh my gosh! I want Weatherford to lose so we can play here next week.
That's true. Well, let's check some scores, Chris.
Let's do that.
Bum, bum, bum. Wagner's in a dogfight with Salisaw, 42-0 and a half. Poto, 24-12, up on Skytook. Bristow's beating Broken Bow, 21-14. Of course, we're 21-7. 27-14, Weatherford Cushing at halftime, so it's a ball game.
It's almost the same play. Number four got. Oh, but he got loose.
He's
going to
score.
Oh, he dropped the ball.
And we got it.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. So what I figured out they were doing with Brayson Lawson is he was mirroring number four the whole game.
Is that what it
yeah,
is?
Yeah, and so he's going back and forth, and he just got loose, and it looks like he's fumbled the ball, and Hilldale has recovered.
I'm not sure why you're arguing out there. The ball's already been, it's turnover.
That's a turnover. All right, with 22.3 seconds left, we're going to get the ball back on our own 2-yard line. We just got to get it where we don't get a safety.
Got no score in Clinton 80 yet. Tuttle's up 24-10 on Newcastle.
Did you say 21-14 Weatherford?
27-14.
27-14 Weatherford winning.
Halftime. Yeah. Cushing scored going in at halftime.
Okay.
Well, I could be making that up, too. Sounded good. We jumped.
My goodness. We did. And that's going to be half distance, so that's going to put it on the 1-yard line.
I think we get a little cushion, push it out, and take a knee, right?
Yeah. I would just sneak Johnny.
And he's sneaking. Oh, he's got 4 or 5 yards there in the play.
Nice. And I don't think we'll down it. We'll just, unless.
We don't have to run another play. Unless they call a timeout.
21-7 is your score, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like we're going to go in at halftime right now. And, wow, what a game so far.
Yeah, great game.
Our defense has 14 points, and so the 3 turnovers. Offense has 7 points, and... anyway, our defensive has allowed 0 points scored against us. They scored on a kickoff return. But, hey, we're going to take a little bit of a break here. We'll leave the camera going.
Yep.
And I'm assuming the Crimson Vanguard, maybe they're not going to
perform. They're not
even. But we're going to leave everything going. Thank you.
Except the sound. We're going to mute it, so don't be alarmed.
DJ Durant! Stepping up, up, always take the risk. Up, up, living life, life. Go hard and don't quit.
Go hard.
Drip, splash, like the ice on the wrist. That's a call I can't miss. Set my goals like a goal, hit the switch. Work, 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 check it off the checklist. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go. About that action, about that action. Let's get active,
let's get active.
That's what I'm asking,
what I'm asking.
Like what's happening,
what's happening.
Skirt, skirt, but don't crash it. My diamonds clashing, like an accident. I take high risk, cause I'm passionate.
High risk, go.
I get it fast, I'm gripping the bag, I'm dashing it.
I get it fast.
We about to go undefeated in all of the matches.
Undefeated, go.
We did it first, she do it the same exactly.
We did it first.
Woo. Yeah.
Woo. 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 Hey. Woo. 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 What? Woo. Woo. Woo.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh. Oh. I'm set.
I'm a star player. W's over L's. Touchdown, the crowd yells. Succeed and we never fail. We out of here, yeah. Ooh, we gotta prevail. We coming to raise hell. They hating, they want us to fail. They were sleeping on the gang and we bombed on them. We got 35 yards on the fourth on them. Screw, screw. He out of here, he gone. It's a touchdown, we home. Bitter destroy, we strong. Teamwork, dream work, nobody did it alone. We hungry, eat to the bone. Nobody can copy and clone. In the position to win, what you gonna do when you won? We gotta go a little harder. Learn from mistakes, be smarter.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh. Oh.
In a position to win. In a position to go,
go.
I'm turning the knob on 10,
10.
And pushing the pedal to flow.
Flow.
I'm learning from all my losses.
Losses.
I am the player and coach.
Coach.
Look at the dab, it's awesome.
Awesome.
Grab your pad, take notes.
No.
I'm on the boat, they riding away with no life best gon' float.
Flow.
I'm in a position, you in a position. What is you complaining for?
Why?
I'm in a position to win, you in a position to lose for show.
Show.
I got back my groove, I'm making a move, and I get the champion though.
Nah,
we kept from the bottom, and now we on top, and we just gon' keep leveling up.
Up.
We here to go platinum, and then we go diamond. Go put that gold medal up.
Up.
And we be rocking so much gold, cause we got the Midas to touch.
Mike.
Second the day in the race, but then there ain't no competition with us.
Nah.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Win.
In a position to go.
Go.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh.
In a position to win.
Oh.
In a position to go.
Oh. Oh.
Go, 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 shorty. It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Cardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. When I pull up out front, you see the Benz on dub. When I roll 20 deep, it's always drama in the club. Now that I roll with Dre, everybody show me love. When you sell like them and them, you get plenty of groupie love. Look, homie, ain't nothing changed. Roll down, G's up. I see exhibit in the cutting, man. Roll them up. If you watch how I move, you mistake before I play up here. Been hit with a few, but now I don't walk with a limp. In the hood, in the LA, they saying 50, you hot. They like me, I want them to love me like they love pop. But I live in New York for sure, they tell you I'm loco. And the plan is to put the rap game in the choke. Oh, I'm fully focused, man. My money on my mind, got a meal out the deal, and I'm still in the grind. Now shorty say she feelin' my style, she feelin' my flow. A girl from Woody, they buy, and they ready to go.
Find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to feel the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need if you need to feel the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug if you're into getting rough. My flow, my show brought me the dough. That brought me all my fancy things. My crib, my cars, my clothes, my shoes. Look, homie, I done came up and I ain't changing. You should love it way more than you hate it. Oh, you mad? I thought that you'd be happy I made it. I'm that cat by the bar toasting.
ladies and gentlemen, and that's the end of your halftime entertainment, which was
none.
Nothing. So thanks for hanging in with us. Hopefully you took a little bit of a break, and we lost the toss and received the first half, so we'll be kicking off this half. Jason, tell me what you like, tell me what you don't like.
I like our defense. Had some clutch plays, been a couple times, but ended up getting two pick sixes, so I really and recovered a fumble.
Yep, defense.
Which we thought was a touchdown.
Defense is playing pretty greedy, and which is great. Giving up the middle of the field, but once we get to kind of to the about the 30-yard line, really clamping down, and had some really great defensive stances. I will say that I think we made a mistake on the all-time score thing. I got a message that
I said that.
Yes, you actually said it, but I kind of backed it up. But I did get. I don't know if it's official or more official, but I believe Chandler Puckett still is the all-time leading scorer.
I would
know.
I wouldn't argue.
So my apologies out there. But ball is live.
That was a silly move.
Oh man, that was number four. Kind of let the ball bounce. It was a live ball, but anyway, so our defense is back on the field. Best part of our game so far tonight.
So while we're switching players, Weatherford Cushing, which is the game we're watching, because we're going to play either.
Well, I'm watching this game, but.
Well, the game we're watching on the scoreboards.
Gotcha.
Because we'll play one of those two teams.
Uh-huh. What's the score?
27-21 Weatherford's up. They were up by
13.
They were up by 13 and a half, and looks like Cushing came right out and scored on them.
Good.
Down the road, Poto, 38-27 on top of Skytook.
All right, it's a little closer than expected.
Skytook's not a bad team.
Nope. Handoff to 34 over the right-hand side. Get to the outside. It's going to be caught by Isom. And
late flag.
Way back here.
Wonder what that would be back here.
Face mask.
Huh. Okay. Bristow was on top of Broken Bow, 28-20 in the fourth quarter.
It's going to be a 15, no, just a 5-yarder.
Still enough new change.
Yep.
Blanchard's all over Tecumseh. Tuttle up pretty good on Newcastle. Clinton 8 is 1-0.
We got
owners.
Quads, right? Am I saying that right? Quads down here. Four receivers in a diamond pattern. And we throw it to the other side, and we've got good position on the offensive pass interference.
Is there a flag?
I don't know.
I don't know. I don't think anybody
there
knew.
There was a flag. There was a flag here at the formation, but no flag down there. Yep.
Legal formation.
Yep.
So the Clinton Ada game says the score is 1-0 final. I guess they're playing soccer down there.
Okay.
I don't understand.
Somebody put something in wrong. I don't think you can do that.
Well, it was 0-0 first quarter when I looked about 20 minutes ago, and now it's 1-0 final. Maybe they just had a coin toss, who won?
That's funny. No? That's a funny statement, actually, during the COVID time. All right, come on, D. It's a first and looks like a 15. Back to pass.
Casey Albin in his face, overthrows him.
Cason Albin is such a quick player. He's having some great games. As the season gets farther along in the season, he gets better and better and better.
Well, it's do or die from here on out.
Do or die. Leave it all on the field.
I know.
Ada had to forfeit, I'm being told.
Wow.
By the most reliable source that I know. Go get that ball! Oh my goodness!
No.
And he's going to score.
Gosh. Almost the sack turned into a touchdown.
Man, he leads him. He leads that player really, really good. And trying to catch. catch him the whole time. I mean, that's literally what he's trying to do, which is obviously it's a very talented kid. But he led that ball twice perfectly now, where Grayson had pretty decent position but can't quite get to the ball. And so just like that, scores 21-14. I mean, it's going to happen. I mean, when you're chasing that kid around the field the whole time. We've got Eric Virgil and Brayson Lawson back deep to receive, and also back there with him, Lamar and Burton. Devin James, Logan Harper, Kanan David, Ty O'Neill, Michael Easer, Rylan Nail, Isom Smith, and who's on the far side there? Kobe Thompson? Kobe Thompson.
Sure.
Do you see this guy kicking during halftime?
I wasn't paying attention.
What was that?
I was eating a pickle.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Run the other way. Upfield.
And that's going to be a block in the back.
Helmet to helmet.
On Hildale.
I guess that's what that is, huh?
Look fist to fist. Bad gummit.
What are we doing?
I don't know.
So it's a 13-yard penalty?
No, this.
I'm not sure what. I don't even know what that call is, so I'll just be quiet.
Yep.
They bump knuckles. John hands ball off right about the one. He's coming around the end. Got a little running room. Knocks it out to about the 12-yard line.
Yeah,
maybe 13.
He should have been tackled at the line or in the backfield. There was a guy right there. But
a good jump cut.
Yeah, able to get away. Pick up a nice 6 yards.
Second down and 4 for the Hornets.
Hasn't been able to really kind of get in a groove or a rhythm yet.
Their
defensive
defense
line
is
good. Really good, and their
linebackers. They're playing really good.
Yep. I mean, pick up of
2?
Yep.
Maybe 3?
Yeah, it's going to be a third and a long one. Jose Gutierrez coming in. Let's see what kind of cushion they give Logan Harper over there.
Backing up now. 7, 8. Handoff is to Virgil, and he didn't get it. Back to the line of scrimmage.
He's going to bring up 4th down. That's a loss.
Tried to run off tackle on that far side of the field and didn't get anywhere. Comes the punt team. I missed that. It was number 4, Isaiah Patterson, who had that touchdown pass for Grove earlier.
Yeah.
Nobody's back.
Go, ball, go.
Don't go that way.
All right, defense, we need you.
That's
you
wrong.
Here.
Number 4, I'm sorry. Gregory McCurdy. That was our number 4.
Yeah. That sounds really familiar,
Jason. And then
Jason.
Throwing ball was thrown by sophomore Carson Trimble, number 9.
Number 4 for Grove's player. I mean, he's a player,
yeah.
and we've had to adjust
for
our defense to try to slow him down. I expect a nice hefty dose of number 34 right here.
Yeah. No hurries.
That's 34, isn't it?
Yeah.
Emmanuel Crawford.
Pick up about 13 on the play.
So the quarterback was a sophomore?
That's what it says.
And he's got some leadership skills.
Yeah, big kid, too.
Yeah.
Another handoff up the middle, and he just... blast through for 5 yards, second down and five. Much there, maybe
a yard,
maybe
yard and a
yard.
Half.
Yep. Third down and four for the Ridge Runners.
All right, Brayson, get your running shoes on. Number four.
Number four just lined up in the H-back and went through a big block, too.
Yep.
There he is again, lined up in the H-back.
34 did not make it.
It's going to be close. Not sure where he spotted that. Well, they got a fourth down,
so all they got to do is get a size of half a football.
Yeah. Well, according to the stick, it's a full yard.
Oh, yep, sure is. I would expect the same thing.
Oh. Number four gets under center.
Oh, and he does not get it.
I think he got bottled up.
He does not get it. Take him down. Oh, don't get a penalty, but draw one. Darren Hayes. Man, defense stance right there. And that's going to be Hornet ball.
They're looking at it, Chris.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? There we go.
There it is.
They didn't measure. Called it Hornet ball, so it's going to be – that's defensive stance again. Okay, offense, let's get a drive. A little bit of a drive. Let's go back to what was working. Did they only have one – they got an outside linebacker standing up over there, but they've only really got one. Oh, look out, Johnny. Look out. Yes.
What in the –
yes.
What kind of
yes,
coverage is
a,
that?
That's an old – go, Dylan.
I think he's going to get it.
He is.
I don't see anything on the
– no, that's a touchdown, Hornets. That's the same play we've done, like, throughout the year, right?
Did you see that?
Where basically Johnny's about to get tackled. Dylan just releases out. He just throws it on the lob out there. And that's a touchdown pass, just like that.
Did you see the receiver or the cover guy? He totally lost Dylan. Just lost him.
Yeah.
That was fortuitous.
I don't know what that is, but yeah, that's awesome.
You know what that is, don't
you? Woo! Jax Whitaker on for the point after attempt. Good snap. Ball's down, kick is up, and it's good. That's going to make it 28-14. With 7:22 left in the third quarter. Whew. It's a game of big plays.
Yes.
Number 18, Alonzo Perez going out there. Maybe he's – I just hadn't seen him out there. We got number 11, Aiden Jenkins. Number 34, Chris Wilson. I think everybody else we've called their name. Dylan's hard to catch once you give him the open field.
Yes. And he's hard to stop if you do.
Yep. I haven't said number 23, Caden Dan's name yet.
No.
He's out there.
He's kicking into the wind. Kicks it straight up in the air again. Number 4 is going to fair catch it at the 34-yard line.
That's actually it's good. All right, Jason. Defense, step up again.
Let's just do it in 4 plays this time, not give them a bunch of action.
I'm not picky.
Here we go.
Oh, good, Darren.
Got him pinned back in the backfield. Good. There it is, Jason, Darren. Cleaned up by Dylan Walker.
Yep.
Going to be a loss, and he's still on the turf.
He's cramping.
Get away from him.
Yeah, I think so. That was nice. Our players were helping stretch him out.
Was that 34?
Yep.
He's been working his tail off today.
Yeah, working hard.
They're going to give the spots about the 31-yard line, so loss of 4. Going to be second down of 14 when he gets loosened up and gets off the field. Let's see, Jack's not on the field today, is he?
What's that?
See, Jack Weaver out today.
No, he's actually, I believe, according to social media, actually, he sent me a text. Maybe he's in New Mexico.
Oh.
Down a little bit of a road trip.
Good for him.
On, down Route 66.
Get your kicks. Sure he didn't get an I-40?
No, he didn't, because he's posted a bunch about it. Always glad to have him on the sidelines, but hopefully he's having a nice trip, too. Okay. Well. He's cramping enough that we're going to have a little bit of a timeout here. A little time to reconvene. It's going to be second.
I wonder if his whole
2nd and 14.
I wonder if his whole lower body cramped.
Looks like they're doing both.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I wonder if his whole lower body didn't just cramp. Yeah. Magnesium oxide. That's what he needs, right?
Magnesium. Yeah. Oxide's okay. I like. I like magnesium glycinate better. That would be my recommendation, ladies and gentlemen.
You need to tell Greg.
Huh? Oh, it's fine.
He got me oxide.
Okay.
Oh, well, that's what the doctor told me to take.
Okay.
So maybe that's why.
And oxide's fine, but glycinate's a little bit smoother and also can help you sleep. And not put you to sleep, ladies and gentlemen, but to actually help you get into a deeper sleep to where you stay asleep a little bit longer.
I started taking it. Yeah. I was having horrible leg cramps every night.
Yeah.
And I started taking it, and I haven't had one since.
Awesome.
Except the one time I forgot to take it. I had one.
Nice.
I was getting weird, like, shin leg cramps in the front.
Yeah.
My wife says she feels like I'm pedaling at night sometimes, so I'm sure that has something to do with it.
All right, 2nd and 14. I don't see number. Yeah, there he is.
Looking to throw to number 2. What got
us throw to number 2?
Oh.
Oh.
Kind of lucky that he ran into him, because if he would have not
ducked. Yeah, he ducked. Instead of jumping like he did in the NFL, he ducked under attack.
That's Triton Chandler, Jr., number 2 with reception. I think that's his first one of the night.
Yeah, I haven't seen that yet.
It's going to bring up 3rd down and about 6 for the Ridge Runners. Started on their own 35. Looking pass again. Throwing to the same guy. That was a bit of a push-off, but that wasn't called.
Kind of the opposite of what we do with Logan Harper.
Yeah.
Same thing's happening to us right now, so let's not fall for the long ball.
Yeah, that's a first
ball.
First down, same guy. He made some space, turned around, and caught the ball.
You're all right, Isom. Just stay on him.
Ball's in the Hilldale territory on the Hilldale 47-yard line.
Yep, there's Fours with the ball. And Brayson with the tackle.
He brought down about the 39-yard line. Pick up of about 6. Going to bring up 2nd down and 4 for the Ridge Runners. Drops back to pass. Got time.
Oh, got wide open.
Oh, thank goodness. That was number two again.
You know what?
Chandler wide open.
Well, you know why? It's because we started jumping that route. I almost guarantee you that was a hitch and go or a little stutter step there, and we jumped that route, and he was wide open, and it was just literally 6 inches off his fingertips, right? I mean, it was right there. Thank goodness.
Yeah, it was definitely a well-designed play. Looking pass, got Darren Hayes in his back pocket. A little screen pass set up, and it was set up well. Cleared everybody out. Tackle from behind by, is that Dylan Walker?
Yeah.
After the pickup of the first down, going to be about the 20-yard line of Hilldale.
Man, great play
perfectly
call.
Perfectly set up, too.
Great play call, perfectly set up. Dadgummit, we fell for it.
They had no black jerseys in the middle of the field except
we were
25
all
yards down.
We were all getting a sack.
Yeah, 25 yards downfield was the only next black jersey. Got a tight end down here. They like to throw to him. He looks like he's blocking, though. He's throwing deep for the end zone. They're going to get a hold on that tight end, too, I'm pretty sure. We'll see, though. Holding, yep. He had, looks like he had Braden Smith by the shoulder pads as he went by him.
Okay, we got 5:09 left in the third quarter, 28-14. Back and Grove up just a little bit, about 10 yards.
Should be on the 30.
34 is back in the game, Mr. Emmanuel Crawford. For the Ridge Runners.
Right as you said that, he reached back and started rubbing his thigh, his left thigh.
We'll see what happens when he takes off running here in a minute.
It's like 24's back in, too.
Yeah.
Still a man short. No, they're going to bring him back
off.
Down to 12 on the play clock, and I don't think they have a play in yet either. 3:06:09, 10:11:05.
They did. Yeah, they had to fire a timeout.
And then they only had 10 out there, too.
They're running everybody off.
In and off, yep. In and off, yeah. And they were going to run out of time and have 10 people on the field.
Let's check some scores, Jason.
Powered by Squirtle. Not sponsored, but
let's recognize our game night sponsor this evening, the Hodge Muskogee Hodge Hyundai.
Oh, okay.
Hodge family does a lot for Muskogee, a lot for Hilldale, and all their dealerships are great. Tell me what.
Okay, so Putto opened it up 52-27. Okay. They're about to clean that game up. Just a little bit left. Fourth quarter, 7 minutes to go. Cushing 28, Weatherford 30.
Oh my goodness.
They scored a field goal. That's all they scored in the second half. Broken Bows on top of Bristow, 34-28.
But Cushing scored twice.
Yeah, Cushing scored twice, yeah.
They were actually maybe ahead by one for a little bit, or...
I don't know when that was kicked, but yeah. Blanchard's destroying Tecumseh. Tuttle, 31-21 on top of Newcastle, 6 minutes to go in the ball game.
I think they left a little early there, but...
Yes. Got him.
Nice. Good job.
Initially hit by Watson Schiller and Tyler Mulcory. Came in like a heat-sinking missile and cleaned that up.
Nice.
I can't believe that by Clint and Ada, man. That's terrible. The forfeit of the playoff game.
That sucks.
Some team new Hilldale's winning 28-14. And Wagner 56-0 over South.
Good grief. Play clock down to 6.
Looking to throw. Got pressure again. Coughing it up. Coming out of the pocket. He's got a person. They overthrew it out.
That was
trying to lead him too much.
Big coverage. Yep.
That was Timber at fourth down, though, I think.
Yep. Ison Smith with the coverage on 23.
Golly. Well, we got to call this. It's third down and 58. No, that's not right.
10, 20, 29. I'd say 29.
29, yep. Ball's on the 39-yard line. Got to get to the 10 for a first down. To the 10.
Let's not let them. You know who I'm looking for? Number four.
Just
we got to cover number four. Get over there.
Jay McWilliams barking orders, getting everybody lined up.
And he does throw it to number four. And you got Brayson Lawson lined up there.
And he batted it down.
Yep, bats it down. Good defense, Brayson.
He had position on everything.
Yep.
You got a punt here, right?
No.
Try to pin him deep.
I mean, the punter's really good. They're in that no man's land.
Yeah, here they come.
Yep. I love saying no man's land.
I can tell.
I say it every time.
And defensive stance.
There's stance.
It's a stand.
Is it stand? Defensive
yeah.
stand? Is yeah. there not a stance?
Well, a stance is a stance, yeah, when you get down and play defense. A stand is when you have a series of downs and you stop them.
Words.
Words are fun.
Roads.
What's going on here?
I don't know. Guy in motion during the punt, and he's not set. I think that should be a penalty because he was not set.
That's going to go into the end zone.
Yep, it sure is.
So that's a net of 19 yards.
He was moving towards the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
Okay. You want me to, I'm not going to be nitpicky. Can't be nitpicky here. All right. Good job, defense, again. Defense is having a great game.
Very good.
Yep.
Giving up a touchdown. Long bomb touchdown.
Oh, yep.
One. The other one was on a kick, so.
Man, this quarter's taking a while. Let's put together a nice little drive here and
yes.
take some time off the clock. I mean, I just want to score.
26 play drive or something.
Yeah. And it's
gonna off is to Virgil. And he's managed to push the pile forward about 4 yards for a second down and six. Line to gain is at the 30. Currently on the 24-yard line. Hang on.
Oh, man, he's out. Go, Dylan.
Is that Dylan Walker?
Hang on the ball. Hang on the ball.
Dylan's still on his feet.
He's still up.
Still driving all the way out to the 40.
He was caught in the backfield immediately and just rumbling, bumbling, stumbling, refusing to go down.
Ball's all the way out to the 46, first and 10, Hildale. That was a
oh, my gosh. Ty O'Neill doing a little stretch
11.
There with his left toe. Hopefully he's not cramping up too bad, although.
18-yard gain, is that right?
I can't add.
It's not by fives?
No.
Number 22's got a little gimp shoulder there running off the field.
A little gingerly.
Yeah.
He's upset.
Number 22 is Braden Pittman, senior, so I said it once, I'll say it again. I don't want to see a senior in a game, in a season. What's going on over here?
I don't know. I'm a little bit tired. Is it a clock issue?
Maybe. Yeah, it must be a clock issue.
Timeout. Everything looks correct to me.
Maybe they had to call a timeout at some point. Did they change anything? Did they burn it?
Oh, 3:20. It went up to 3:30, so
okay.
We must have.
They must have stopped it when they called the official timeout there.
Yeah.
In a timely manner. All right. And off to Virgil. He's going to run right behind number 43.
Oh,
he lost the ball.
And
they got it. God bless him here.
Number
40 recovered. That's Wesley Downing.
All right, defense back out on the field. Well, that was unfortunate. I didn't see what happened. He didn't really get hit. So
I think somebody just punched in, punched it out. So it's going to be first and 10, Grove football at the Hildale 48. So that's not idea. That was. Let's go. Handoff's number 34, and he is hit right at the line of scrimmage, and barreled down.
Good.
It's like Tyler McCoy, Jaden McWilliams, Darren Hayes, and Michael Easer all in on the tackle.
Everybody in there. They give him back to the line of scrimmage. You said that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you said it.
Because she's got, you know. Drops back to pass. Short drop. He's got double coverage and throws it right on the money. Right on the money. Number 24th reception. That's Caden Forbes. Big pass into double coverage. It's going to bring first and 10 for the Ridge Runners at Hill 15.
That, number one?
24. Playing slot down here on this play. Slot at the bottom of your screen. Handoff's number 34, and he runs it to his own man.
Oh,
and he's trying to run away, and he's still running away. And we're not tackling. We're just hitting our shoulders into
Taysom
somebody.
Taysom had a lot of pressure on him. Then Watson couldn't get him either, and he got out to the outside but wasn't able to really pick up anything. So that's great. Big loss of about six.
Yeah, big loss. I think 24 may be a little shaken up from that last play, that touchdown. He had to contort pretty good to get reach back and grab that, and he's still kind of gingerly moving around. That last play, he really didn't do anything. He just kind of stood there. Okay, now he's running.
Number four.
Across the middle. Overthrows.
Oh. They're going to call roughing the passer, I bet.
Oh, no. I was watching the ball. I didn't watch it. Dadgummit. Sure enough. Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Don't even be giving him anything, guys.
Half the distance, it's going to be at about the 12. Wow. 10 and a half yard line. Man, that puts an automatic first down. Automatic first down?
Yeah. Yeah. Still actually get a first down. First and 10 from the 11, so they can...
Yeah.
Technically get a first down at the one. Man, they take a long time to get plays in, don't they?
They do, and they don't get nervous about it. I mean, I get nervous.
Quarterback's going to keep it, runs around the end, makes some people miss, comes back across the middle, and he's brought down about the 7 or 8 yard line there. Looks like they're going to give him to the 7. This will be second down and six.
Second and 5. Got it on the 6 yard line there.
No, you get them all the way to 6, huh?
Yep. Okay.
I'll give our band props. They have not stopped playing.
Oh,
except
my
they took
they
a break at halftime.
Yeah,
they played
the
entire
game. They had to use another timeout.
Yeah, they sure did, didn't they? Another timeout taken.
That's their second one of the half, so they've got one timeout left. We've got a 28-14 ball game. They're driving, closing in on another touchdown.
Minute 17 to go in the third quarter. So Tuttle, Newcastle's the final. Weatherford Cushing's up 34-30, 2 minutes to go in the fourth.
You're kidding me.
I'm not kidding you.
34.
Well, according to score, it'll look.
34-30, 2 minutes left?
2 minutes.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know who has the ball or anything like that, so I can't tell you, but whatever it is, it's exciting.
Oh, we got to finish this game.
Quarterback drops back. He's got a man wide open. That's a tight end right there. Nobody covering him.
Yep, that's touchdown, Grove.
Oh, the old tight ends.
Good
always
play.
A good weapon.
I mean, it's good play. I mean, excellent play, excellent execution. So it's 28-20, pending the extra point. Make it 28-21. Turnovers.
Right.
Take advantage of that and turn that turnover into 7 points. 28-21 with a minute 10 left in the third quarter. So a lot of football left to play. Hornets are going to have to keep playing. This game is not even close to being over.
Not at all. Lots of football left.
We look like we're dragging.
13 minutes left.
We look like we're dragging. We need to get some energy and get some drive in us. Back to receive the kick deep. Number 6, Brayson Lawson. 1, Eric Virgil. 7, Lamarion Burton.
Kicks a little pooch over. Oh, man, perfect. I thought that was going to go out of bounds. Yeah, that great spin. And we got some running room, though.
Yes, we did.
All the way out to about the 38-yard line. Good return. Going to give him a 37.
Great field position to get started.
So defense got good starting field position. 38, I think.
Did you say defense got good starting
field? Offense, I did. Virgil running, not getting much there. Maybe a 2. You're going to give him 2 yards. Time's ticking. Probably last play of the third quarter. Guess unless we score.
Or we pass it. And it's incomplete.
And jet sweep to Dylan Walker. He's going to be wrapped up. Not much there, maybe a yard. Never went down.
Yeah, number 4, I think, just literally held onto his leg for life. And that will be the end of the third quarter, and we will be moving to the fourth quarter. Up by 7 points with the ball. It's going to be third. No, is it third already?
Third down, yeah.
Third and 7.
I'm just staring at my phone hoping this updates. nothing else is surprising. Wagner advances. Poto advances. Blanchard advances. Bristow, Broken Bow. Bristow came back and beat Broken Bow.
Wow.
35-34. Bit of a surprise.
Yep. Broken Bow didn't have a game last week.
Nope.
Wow.
That's interesting. Broken Bow's season's finished. Give me an update. Still says 2 minutes, same score. I can only assume somebody's so excited they're not updating the score.
Yep.
All right. Let me change the quarter to fourth quarter.
All right. So we got to finish this game. We need a drive. We need first down.
No more turnovers.
No more turnovers.
Unless we're the ones getting them.
That's right. We take advantage of those. Done a good job of that this game. But they took advantage of the most recent one. And too close of a game.
Yes. Fumbled inside a hill. 38-yard line, and they managed to put it in with pass to their tight end, Jaden Hill. Tight's dropping back to throw. Connects Eric Virgil, and he
incomplete. My goodness.
That was a slow call.
Yes,
you see
it
him?
Was.
I was like, what's going on? But I think he had it either way, but so.
So it's going to be.
We're going to punt, I'm sure.
Oh, fourth and seven. This is right in.
Fourth and six.
Fourth and six, right kind of middle of the field. We'll see what they give us. 11:51 left in the fourth quarter.
Jack's back there to punt. Kicks it right. Nice.
Nice.
Going to be a good bouncer. Looks like it may stop. Going to be inside the 10. Going to be dead about the 6-yard line. So good punt. That's a great swing and field position.
Riley Bell, the snapper down there to cover up the ball.
They're usually the first people down the field because they're uncovered.
That's right.
That's a good thing.
All right. So deep in their own territory, Grove will take over. Our defense has given up
a couple big plays.
They've had four times on defense, and we've given up two scores this half. Pretty sure.
Right.
We need some excitement.
One was a deep, big play, and the other one was a big play to get down deep, and then a little pass out to the tight end. All right, going to hand off number 34. Is that 24? That's 24.
Pick up about three. Brings up second and seven. Handoff again, a little about the same.
Late flag on the play. Be a hold.
Hold. It's
yeah,
going to be
sure
a hold.
Is.
We will accept that.
Same score. They changed to 1 minute remaining in the fourth quarter on the Weatherford Cushing.
It's a lot of timeouts.
I'm not sure.
TV timeouts.
I'm not sure what's going on.
Yeah.
Be a hold at the 10-15. So
is it a hold on defense?
No way.
Personal foul, face mask. Dad,
I thought I saw a hold. So they're going to get the ball all the way out to the 30 after that costly penalty. Saw this last drive. Remember, they had a late hit on the quarterback.
Yep.
Another 15-yarder. Don't need to be helping the other team with yards, that's for sure. They're going to do that quad formation again, looks like.
Yeah, which they were a legal formation last time, legal man downfield when they ran it. So, 2-3, they look good. Oh, they threw it to that.
He's throwing deep.
That's
a jump ball.
That's a jump ball. That's Brayson Lawson. You got to be kidding me. Jump ball goes the offense, doesn't it?
I don't know. I'm not going to lie and tell you I didn't.
Well, according to what they just
called. Looks like they both had it. So. Just not one on the clock.
I don't know. Hand off to 34. Taken down pretty immediately right at the line of scrimmage.
Michael Easer. Going to give him a yard, it looks like.
I couldn't tell who made that tackle.
Number 8, Michael Easer.
Oh, gotcha. Grayson's still talking to that referee over there that he had that ball. going to be.
You call legal formation. Yeah. Again. Or false start, maybe.
I didn't see anybody move, but maybe it did.
I thought I saw somebody on the end of the line. It seemed like they got out of there like a shotgun blast, but I just thought he was just moving.
Why is that the clock going?
Wasn't
an incomplete pass.
Yeah.
Ball! Still on down! Get there, Casey! Oh my goodness, you guys, take him down!
He's going. That's a loss of about 18 yards.
Oh my goodness.
Flag. Are you serious? I just got a text that Cushing intercepted the ball
face
with
mask.
34 seconds left.
Another face mask.
You hear that?
Yep. So Cushing won?
Well, it's not over. Still 34-30, but...
You gotta be kidding me! Another face mask.
Yeah. Still lost 4 yards? 5 yards? So, it's gonna bring up second down at about 14. It's 5 seconds left. Four.
Oh, that's motion.
It was.
Four,
he was moving for the ball.
Go get that.
Oh, he's wide open, too. Golly. Get him down. Long pitch and catch all the way down to the Hilldale 1 yard line. It's going to be. They false started.
I thought number four took off.
He was gone before the ball was ever started.
They didn't call it, though.
Cushing won, 34-30.
Well, how about that? Now we've got to win this game.
Yeah, we got to win this game now. Thank you to my score man out there. Also a board member, I think.
With the ball. Goes to the outside. Looks like he's going to make it in for the touchdown. That's going to...
So... Going to put him down by one. I'm not sure if they'll kick or go for two here or what, but we got to get some offense going, whatever they do. Looks like they are lining up to kick. Snaps down, kick is up, and it looks good.
That's good. That's going to tie a ball game with 8:40 left in the fourth. This half, Grove has scored 21 points, and the Hornets have scored 7.
Not idea.
Nope. Momentum definitely going Grove's way right now. We need something to help us. We need some leadership on the field and on the sideline, and we need something to get us going. We need a big play.
So we're the only game still playing right now. In 4A. I don't know about across the state, but
yeah.
4A there. So big momentum swing for Grove now, after scoring 2 touchdowns unanswered. Is that Virgil?
Yep.
Oh. Tried to sidestep somebody and ran right into his own man. Brought down about the 27-yard line of Grove. I'm sorry, of Hilldale.
And that's where the offense will take over.
I see a lot of heads now. It's just, it's time ball game. Get your heads up. Get into it. Let's go. All right, let's see. Got the heavy package in with pistol formation. Gutierrez back there in the backfield. Motion coming around. Dylan Walker gets it. Gutierrez lead blocking. Walker gets a couple other blocks, cuts back, runs down the sidelines, gets out to about the 37-yard line, pushed out of bounds finally.
1, 2, 3, about seven. Pick up about seven, maybe eight. Yep.
Yeah, going to get made.
Ball security,
mm-hmm.
Very important.
I guess he wasn't out of bounds. They whistled it before he went out. He was out of the clock storeroom. Virgil gets the handoff.
Oh,
loses the ball again. Grove got it. Recovered by number 50, Jesse Amell. Amell.
We need to take a stand right here.
Oh, my goodness. Pitch out to number 34. Got a swarm of Hornets coming. Not sure who was the initial tackler. So Darren Hayes at the back end of that. The pass has pressure,
oh.
And he's got it wide.
Oh, my gosh.
Open.
And just like that, the Grove Ridge Runners are ahead. 7:17 left and to go in the ball game. I don't know what happened there. If it was just a well-designed play or what, but we were blown.
No, it wasn't a well-designed play.
That.
I think our pass coverage thought there he was going to run the ball.
Kick is up and it's good. Now it's 35-28. Grove.
Yep.
Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, same story again. We need the momentum is on the wrong side, and we need something good to happen. I expect another little pooch kick here, or kind of a deep pooch, but. With plenty of time.
Oh, fell down.
And we'll take over on our own 26-yard line.
Yeah. That is awesome, Smith, back there.
Okay.
Tailback spot. And he gets the ball.
He does. Nice pickup. First down. Pick up about five.
It's about the 30 and a half yard line or so. Give him the 31. Like same play, Austin Smith up the middle. He's still moving. Still running his feet and out to about the...
almost enough for a first down.
35, going to be about
looks right at it. And yeah, this guy's calling a first down. That's going to be enough for a first down. Good running, Isom.
They're going to move the chains. All right. First and 10, Hill, though. Back to doubles. Two wides, two slots. Rex Lawson in motion.
And
he's looking to throw.
He's got coverage on him, though. Oh.
Well, I don't hate the trick play.
No, me neither. Me neither.
I'm aborted
ball for it.
Yeah. That was scouted well. I think Brayson probably could have faked that a little better, like he was going to throw it and tucked it and ran and probably got some good yardage.
Yep.
In a stacked formation.
Johnny's just going to run with it.
Up the middle, up to about the 42.
Yep.
Rip third and five for the Hornets. Third and four. Let's doing lots of throwing here. I think needs to happen a little more. Get that middle softer. Johnny drops back to pass. Guns across the middle. Brayson Lawson got it at the 50. Still going out to the Grove 40-yard line. First and 10, Hildale into Grove territory.
Big time play. Good play.
Going to be all the way down to 38. Drosso, the keeper, picking his spots. Pick up of another 7 yards. Is that right? Yeah, 7 yards. Going to bring up second and three. Good mix of plays coming.
Great balance.
We may get a little conservative there for a little bit. Had the lead and got a little conservative, and now I think it's changing. Same formation where Brayson caught it across the middle.
Same type of play. Good. You're good. You got time. You got time. You got time.
Throw it away.
Oh, no.
That's exactly what you shouldn't have done. 100% what you shouldn't have done.
Threw interception.
Just throw it away. It was second down.
And that's going to be Grove ball with 4:48 left in the ball game. Grove ahead 7, 35 to 28.
All right, 29-yard line. Grove takes over, 4:48 to go. Hey, we've scored twice on defense. We can score again. Of course, they'll probably never throw the ball again. But.
Yeah, I mean, we're getting 34-4, 34-4, and then throw it on 24 every once in a while.
Pushing forward back to the line of scrimmage, so no gain on the play.
No face mask called. That's good.
There's 11 Hornets over there by the tackle.
And they will take all 40 seconds.
Well, they do that anyway.
Yeah. I mean, they do it regularly, which is smart.
They were doing it when they're down three scores, too.
Yeah. 34 again.
Got a little bit of cushion, a couple yards anyway, maybe three. Gonna bring up third down and 7 for the Ridge Runners. Clock's ticking, 3:48 to go. Off to number 24, barreling through, pick up about 6, going to bring up 4th and maybe pick up a 5, 4th and 3 for the Ridge Runners. He runs violently, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he runs straight with his head, too.
4th and 2. 4th and 2. If I was coaching here, I'd go ahead and punt it.
Man. I would too, but
you don't want to turn the ball over right here. We're going to try to get jumped, and they might call a timeout. Of course, they only have one timeout left, too.
Who's the punter? Because he could just be out there.
It's 34.
That's right.
It's the running backs. The
they did. They called their last timeout. Well, I'm glad we didn't jump off sides.
That'd have been real disappointing.
Yep.
Probably been the nail in the coffin there. 2:32 to go in the ball game. Hilldale's down by 7. 35-28 your score. They've had 21 unanswered points here in the second half, haven't they? Is that right? 21 unanswered? Because they got the 14,
yeah.
He got the 28.
Yep.
And they, yeah. Scored 21 more. So, yeah, it looks like they're going to punt. 34 is their punter. And he's been drilling the ball all night, too.
Yep.
It's Emmanuel Crawford. So, and I'm assuming if they wanted to fake it, they got the right guy.
Yep. So, no kidding. Yep. It'd be hard to stop them.
Looks like they're in the right formation, though, to punt. I don't see anything. There we go. Well.
They've got that motion. They did. They've been doing
that.
Yeah,
that's right. That's right. And he gets rid of it quick, and it's got some distance on it.
Go, Grayson. Go, Grayson. Go, Grayson. Great position. Great position. Oh, and we got a penalty.
He was, yeah. They're going to call a black on a block in the back against Dylan Walker there.
That was a block in the back. I think maybe a
blindside. Maybe, yeah. Oh. I think it's the same call, though, isn't
it? Dadgummit. Yeah.
Block, yeah. It's 10 yards, so we'll be back on our own.
50.
It'd actually be a Grove 49, I believe. 48, maybe. It's a 10-yard penalty. Good return, nonetheless.
Yep. 2:21 left in the ball game. 35-28. Hornets behind. We've got 3 timeouts left. Grove has 0 left. Ball security.
Well, cart before the horse. Do we go for 2?
Oh, my gosh. I can't believe you asked that. Yes.
I put a preference on it. Tyson Smith in the backfield. Handoff is to – they're going to try that pass
and
again, and it's
it
open.
It worked this time. It worked this time. Go, Ty. Good.
Ty O'Neill with the reception all the way down about the 9-yard line.
Why is the – well, I guess it still runs because they just keep it going. Ty O'Neill with a great catch. Good throw by Brayson Lawson.
They should
Lawson.
Stop it to move the chains. Oh, well, they don't need the chains, so no, they're not going to stop it.
Yeah.
So, first and goal from the 10.
Johnny's going to keep it.
Hang on to the ball, Johnny. Hang on to the ball, Johnny.
Two hands.
Hang on to the ball, Johnny.
He's going to be brought down about the half-yard line. Yes.
It's going to be second and goal. Clock is running.
No.
Oh, we just called a timeout. 1:27 left in the ball game.
Folks, my broadcast partner is pacing like a caged animal.
I don't know.
You hold on the ball and get to the goal line. I know that much, right? You hold on to the ball and get to the goal line, don't worry about everything else.
That's a Blevins call right there. All right, here comes back out the offense. 1:27 left.
You try the jet sweep maybe if you get the two, if you go for two.
Oh, stop. No, I bet we line up in that swinging gate and see our options.
We got a super heavy package now. We got a fullback, tailback, and a halfback. Johnny's going to get under center.
I bet. Oh, we're
kind of a push.
Nope. Hand off to Jaden Williams.
He's in. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Hornets. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. I kick.
Do you kick?
I kick. Swinging gate. Okay, we are going to be lining up in the swinging gate.
How much did they practice this? I'm so nervous.
A whole bunch, I hope. I'm nervous.
Count hands. 2-4s.
Here comes Eric Virgil out here behind this line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We've got 7 on. Oh. Shoot, we had him for just a second. Yeah, we had to call timeout. Shoot, if we could have got the ball out here to Eric Virgil, we had a
six. Oh, Logan was all the way at the top screen. I didn't see him. So there was the 11. Holy moly.
Yeah, Jax is going out there. You know what I'd love to see right here? Remember Les Miles at LSU, the pitch behind the holder to the kicker?
I never understood how that worked.
Florida, he just pitches it behind his head.
Well, no, I get that, but his knee's down.
But he's the holder.
I know, but it just never. He shouldn't be able to do that play. Should have to be pitched to the punter or the kicker. I mean, so we're gonna line up. Man, I'd have been. All right, come on! I can't watch as I'm watching the screen. Kicks down.
It's good. It's good. We got a tie ball game.
Jesus.
Woo! 1:22 left in the game. Hornets answered. Got a tie ball game. Got some momentum with this.
Minute 22 to go.
We have two timeouts.
Kick it away. Kick it out of bounds. I don't care. Kick it out of bounds.
Defense. Let's go. Troy Jax Whitaker, kickoff. I would expect him to kick it right over here to Coach Blevins. And
whew,
that would have been great.
And their coaches right now all said woo.
Yeah.
That wasn't us. That was them.
number 5 bobbled the ball a little bit, but covered it up on the ground. Minute 19 left in the game. If I sound nervous, ladies and gentlemen, it's because I am.
Yep.
Okay.
I'm a Hilldale football fan. No kid playing, so unlike you. Okay, here we go. Defense lined up. They're in tight formation. They got a man in motion. He's going to get the jet sweep. That's number 24.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
And he's got plenty of room. He might be gone to the house.
He's going to go Dylan.
Like Dylan might be able to catch him. He's going to knock him out of bounds about the 4 yards.
Oh, my gosh.
Gosh, dang it. Come on.
Well,
what? Where's that? 3?
3 yard line. It's going to be first and goal from the 3. The minute 07 left.
He's going to wind the clock, and they're going to take. They don't even have the right personnel on the field. That's good news. And they don't have a timeout.
Don't start it.
Oh, they restart. The play clock.
Dang, a heck of a run by 24.
Good blocking for sure.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Get the clock all straightened out, I guess. And maybe hand off number 24 and he walks it in. Minute 6 to go in the ball game. We had a chance to get it back and score and tie it up.
Sweet. Kick is up and looks good. It's good. Scores 42-35 with a minute 6 left in the ball game. We've still got 2 timeouts. Basically, it's the same that it was just a minute ago.
Yeah, but 40 seconds less.
How many seconds did it take us to score last time?
I don't know. Not sure, man. I know we got 66 seconds to score.
I'm not doom and gloom yet. Not doom and gloom yet.
Here we go. Number 14 doing the kicking again. He's been doing the place kicking tonight. Nicholas Alsup.
Kicked a bunch.
Uh-oh, ball's on you. Well, he's going to hold it.
Well, how about that?
This wind's picked up a little.
Yep.
Kind of puts up in the air, and that is.
Don't.
Oh, stay on your feet. Stay on your feet.
He is
stay on your feet.
He is on his feet. He is on his feet. Gets pushed out of bounds.
Flags. See flags?
Right at the 50. No, no flags. Pushed out of bounds right at the 50. We've got 56.4 seconds left. 2 timeouts. Right at the 50-yard line, right at midfield.
That was LaMarion Burton who caught the kickoff and then went to the top of your screen and pitched it back to Brayson Lawson, who managed to get the ball out to midfield. So, great field position, 56 seconds to go. I expect a lot of throwing on this possession, don't you?
Yeah.
No ground and pound.
unless there's a huge lane and we just run it to – have to pick up a first down or something.
Aye, aye, aye. I can feel my hair getting gray. Johnny drives that pass, got a man in his face. Pass is caught by,
and he's out of bounds too. Good.
Great. That was, why is my brain? Iceman Smith.
Yep.
Came out of the backfield and caught that.
Pick up about 5 yards on the
play. Good, man. He held on to that. I'm proud. He had had a lot of offensive plays this year, and he held on to that like a champ.
Come on, Brayson.
We don't know the play. Okay, there you got it.
We got 23 seconds.
Oh, plenty of time. Johnny back to pass. Got a good. He's got a lane, big lane up the middle, and he's running. Tuck it. Oh God.
Clock is stopped. Everybody, get up there and get on the line.
So head off football all the way down to the 23-yard line. I'll get it right in a second. Johnny's looking to pass. He's got that lane in the middle again. He dumps it off to
Oh no,
he dropped it. Wow.
Clock stops. 27 seconds.
Man, that was good quick thinking. He got it. I think his hips started going upfield before he had the ball in his hands, didn't he?
Yeah. It's gonna bring up
that was Iceman Smith 27.
Again. 27.6 seconds left. We still have 2 timeouts.
They should just run what they're running every play because it's working. People are getting open. Clock stop. Second down and 10. So he's looking. Got some pressure claps, and he's going to try to run it. He's going to get brought down. Call timeout. Timeout taken. Timeout. Right on top of it. 19.3. Going to be third down and 10. Like their number 40 might be a little dinged up. He's been playing his hind end off all game too. Ay, ay, ay. So we don't have to score, but we got to get a first down at least. We got another timeout.
Well, we got 2 plays to get a first down. That's not going to leave us with much time.
Right.
So.
Doggies. 42-35 is your score. Hilldale behind. 19.3 seconds to go in the ball game. So we got to get something going here. That's I don't know what the numbers are, but that's what, 4 plays maybe if you can stop the clock every play?
Yep.
I'm sure there's a magical number in there somewhere, but I don't know what it is. Especially if he's having to check down a lot of receivers, that's burning time every time.
Mm-hmm.
But better than throwing it away, right?
Yep.
Or throwing it to the wrong team.
Yep.
All right, here we go. Third down and 10. Oh, he's got pressure in his face.
You're still up. You're still up. Go, Johnny.
Out of bounds.
Go, Johnny. Yes.
They got a horse collar. That's going to be a horse collar. Clock stop. Oh, man. There's no way a half second went off the clock. We're going to get in trouble for that one. 0.6 seconds went off the clock on that play, Chris.
Shh.
It'll be spot foul, so it'll be on about the 5-yard line, first and 10, Hilldale. They're going to have to take some time off the clock. I don't know what it's going to be, but what? I don't know what they're talking about here.
Are they trying to say it's not a horse collar?
Or maybe they're talking about the clock, too, or something. Maybe they're all discussing it. Jersey, I think, is still a horse collar, I believe.
It was last week, yeah.
All right, so personal foul, horse collar is the call. So it's going to be Hilldale football, first and 10 from the 5. They're going to go talk to our sidelines. Yep. Probably adjust the clock a little bit. I don't know what. But
2 seconds.
So first and goal and some amount of time left. Our lineman, and you just chill out for a second. Well, win or lose, it's been a heck of a game. Grove was a tough team fighting back.
Yeah.
Nothing, just lots of hard nose running and some big pass
plays.
Take
3 seconds off the clock, I think, so it's going to be 15.5. Blevins was holding up 3, so I'm guessing they're working on it down there. I don't want to go tell them what to do because I'm assuming something's not working.
Well, they got coach next door with a headset on. So.
Yeah.
That's a little tricky.
We're getting a chance to rest, but it's killing our momentum that we've got going on.
It's always a little tricky when trying to change the clock and it doesn't want to work for you. Why won't you change? What in the world?
Are the coaches telling them?
I don't know.
I don't hear them over there.
Not my deal.
Oh, 12.5. Man, okay. They took
6 seconds.
6 seconds off the clock.
That's probably right. That was a lot of scrambling and a run and everything.
Isom's up in the line. Empty backfield. Grayson Lawson.
Johnny's got the corner. He's got it. He's got it.
Yes.
Touchdown. Oh my gosh. I'm so.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here comes Jace, number 11. We're going to do the same. We're doing the same thing that we did last time. We got it! We got it!
It's in.
We got it.
2 points, baby.
We scored. It's going to be 43-42 with 7.1 seconds left in the ballgame. Oh, my goodness. Oh.
2-point conversion. Oh. We go up a point. 7.1. Kick the ball out of bounds.
Kick the ball out of bounds.
That's deep. Kick it out of bounds. Kick it out of bounds.
I don't know. Swift kick it. No, I don't.
Swift,
we ran some time off. I mean, that was one play they had last time. So we got to play some defense. We have got to play some defense for one play.
They have no timeouts.
No timeouts. Scores 43-42 with 7.1 seconds left. Your Hornets on top right now.
I can see my heart beating. Is that bad?
I
can see it.
I can feel mine in my temples. So.
Well, you've had a headache most of the night too, so that's not helping.
Holy moly. Let's put that ball where we need it to be.
We're going to, after this game, I'm going to do a little wrap-up. I think Chris is going to run down on the field and take a picture with his son. So. All right, man. He just
big old pooch.
Clubs it straight up in
did
the air.
Did not call for a fair catch. Did not. They're gonna try. They're gonna try to score right here. And that's.
They still got it.
They still got it. Get over here. That's a forward lateral. Throw a flag. That's two forward laterals. That's three forward laterals. It's game. Ball game.
Ball game.
Hornets win. Hornets win. Yes.
So let's get everything adjudicated. They're gonna say, he's gonna tell them it's a forward. So let's see. Let's watch the white hat. Just make 100% sure.
They threw it forward times.
Yeah.
Yep. Declined.
Ball game.
Yes! Woo!
Yeah!
Oh, your Hornets win 43-42 in a barn burner of a game.
Great game, Drells. Any of you guys listening over there, great game. You guys, you got a good team.
Oh, my goodness.
Good job.
Oh, my goodness.
That's
and
the...
Guess what, Jason? We'll be here next Friday night.
Is that how that works?
Yes. Yes. I think we have home... I'm 99% sure we have home field advantage. Weatherford has lost to Cushing. And I think we're the higher seed, so I think we've got Cushing coming to town next Friday night.
Hot dang.
Hot dang.
Great team win. Johnny DeRossett, last two drives, he just turned into a beast mode.
Yep. Great finish. Great way to not give up. Whenever I wanted to give up, I mean it was not looking good. So
I mean they had all the momentum.
My goodness, what a game!
Man, heck of a game.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for tuning in. I'm sorry we had a little bit of disruption in the middle of the game, but we got it back on, and hopefully you got to finish it with this. And we will we'll be here again next Friday night online. If you can't make it out, be sure to tune into our broadcast.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to run down on the field. All right. Chris Schiller signing off. Thanks.
All right, so 43-42 is your final. Hilldale pulls out the big win in great fashion. They tried the pitch a plenty at the end on a kick to try to get some score, and it went well until they started going forward. And then a flag was thrown, and no matter what happened, it would have been the end of the game, I'm pretty sure. So Hilldale takes it. They're moving on to the third round of the playoffs, and I'm pretty sure they play Weatherford. And if what Chris is saying is right, then they will play – we'll be here because we're the higher seed because – I'm sorry, not Cushing. Cushing beat Weatherford, my bad. So we'll be playing Cushing, and I think it'll be here because they ended up beating Weatherford at Weatherford, which was the number two team in the state. So that was a big battle, big win for Weatherford, and just proud of these guys. I coached all these seniors, a lot of these seniors in football for, I guess, probably 7 years in Little League, all the way from first grade on. So I'm really proud of these guys, and this has been a fun season. I've had some time away because of illnesses a couple times, and but I'm here and I'm excited, and we will be back next week. And with that, we're gonna sign off from Hilldale Stadium. Thank you and good night.